Well, my name is Avery Dulles, and I'm a Jesuit priest. I was ordained back in 1956. I entered the Jesuit order in 1946. My background is that I came to the Catholic faith principally through my undergraduate studies at Harvard in the years 1936 to 1940. And I got very much interested in theology at that time. It was sort of a new world to me. I did a lot of philosophical studies, mostly classical philosophy, Plato and Aristotle and others. And then I got into medieval philosophy and theology, St. Augustine and St. Thomas, and did a lot of work on medieval culture, medieval literature and art, and studied the Reformation and the Renaissance. And in the course of those studies, I was very much struck by the theologians whom I read, that they were working out of revelation, out of an attitude of faith, and were seeing the world through the eyes of faith. I did my undergraduate thesis on Pico della Mirandola. In fact, it was published as a book by the Harvard University Press in 1941. He was an Italian philosopher, theologian of the 15th century, and a very remarkable person. And in reading his work, I again was fascinated by the perspective of Catholic theology. So that's where I got my great desire to enter the Catholic Church. I did actually enter in the fall of 1940 when I was a first-year law student. I didn't enter the seminary or the Jesuits immediately because the war started in 1941, and I was in the naval service as a reserve officer from 1941 to 1946. So when I got out of the Navy in 1946, I entered the Jesuits, which I really wanted to do for the previous 6 years. And I studied at Woodstock College in Maryland and got my doctorate from Rome and taught at Woodstock College and the Catholic University of America. In the last 12 years, I've been here at Fordham University. So that's something of my autobiography. And my interest in theology, as I say, was generated even before I became a Catholic. I never asked to be assigned to teaching theology, but superiors decided that's what they wanted me to do, and I was very happy that that was their decision, because to me it's the most interesting subject one could possibly pursue. I find that even philosophy, which does interest me also, the philosopher generally works with one hand tied behind his back because he's trying to say what things would look like from the standpoint of pure reason if we did not have any religious faith, if there were no revelation, if Christ had never come and risen from the dead. And that limits what you can say as a philosopher, I think. But as a theologian, you're free to draw on all the sources of knowledge and deal with the most profound human problems, problems of where we come from and where we're going. And philosophy has been my passion, theology has been my passion for the last 50 years and more, and I presume it will continue to be so as long as I last.